Get out of the way. Get out of the way. Get up, you fat ass.
Hey guys, I just want to give you a brief introduction to my video. I worked really hard on this today. This will be the new format for my videos moving forward because I was just trying to combine videos of different days and I was getting so convoluted and I'm not good at editing yet. And this Mac is a 6-year-old piece of shit. So anytime, once a week when I have a day where I've got my physical therapy, my personal training, my coaching, my online coaching, a good day of nutrition, I want to get it all in one video so you guys have something that you can gather information from. So, without further ado, enjoy it. I'll see you at the end.
What's up, guys? It's Wednesday, July 15th. I'm at physical therapy. It's officially been 2 weeks since my accident. This is my 5th physical therapy visit since then. I'm seeing my doctor today as well, so hopefully we'll have lots of new information and things that I can start doing at physical therapy that I haven't been allowed to do yet. Yesterday, I'll have a video of this probably too at the beginning of my introductory. I had to go to Nashville to pick up all my things. Needless to say, it did not go well. A lot of things were stolen, taken, missing, broken. I'll get into more of that because it's fucked. It's an awful situation, but hopefully I'll have Chase say hey here in a minute, and I'm gonna do a video of each one of my exercises today as well, and do like a full day of physical therapy and a lot of my training today as well. So stay tuned.
Dougie's tassel, I'm just dugging in it.
You actually used to be a Game of Thrones generator where you could put in your name and it would generate all kinds of things based off your name.
Really?
Yeah.
I hope there's no like Game of Thrones spinoff that you're gonna let it die.
No, there are. They've already confirmed them.
Sweet. Glad I said that.
Yeah. Sorry to ruin your day further.
Nah, man. Everything's good.
And make it real slow on the way down, tighten that quad up.
I can feel this way more though.
Good.
Keep being able to keep my legs up. Okay. Yeah, it actually makes more sense than what you were talking about too.
She loves it. Ooh, that little quad.
This is definitely the most range of motion I've had. It feels really damn good. Yeah, as long as you get one full rep in there, it's good.
So you'll see it. So
oh, yeah.
You mean I get to personally serve our new metal overlords? Sign me up.
All right. Same thing?
Yeah.
Go ahead and get started.
Let's hold it for a little bit longer if we can. Good. Yes, Lord Megatron, I will absolutely put supreme gas inside of you. You need your oil changed. Okay.
There. I don't know why I hit my plane on second. It's a fucking Santa car.
It's awesome.
One last thing to end on that I've been experimenting with. You get to witness it. Supposed to be good for anti-inflammatory benefits. Supposed to help your sleep. Supposed to help you relax. Let's find out. Ooh, I've been trying to do 5-minute cold showers every day. If you can stomach it, I highly recommend it. I always feel better after it, but fuck, it sucks to get started. What's up, guys? Just got back from physical therapy a little while ago. I actually have been talking to myself for 5 minutes and didn't realize that I wasn't videoing. My day's been going really good the past 2 days, by the way. That is pure sarcasm. They have not been great. I wanted to video what I made for my first meal of the day. I always fast going into physical therapy for anti-inflammatory reasons. I feel leaner, just cleaner whenever I'm doing light, any kind of like light work. I recommend, especially for males, not for females specifically, to do like some light fasted movement first thing every morning. I feel great when I do it. I think it's good for your hormones. It's good for your energy. It's good for
being steady throughout the day. So yeah, meal one, I made my world famous dog shit looking pancakes, but they are delicious. These are Kodiak cakes, the buttermilk ones. I couldn't recommend them enough. They're super high in protein. They're fluffy. I make them with almond milk and one egg, makes them fluffy. They're seriously delicious though. It's like 30 grams of protein, maybe 50 grams of carbs, a little bit of fat from the egg. And then my delicious green smoothie. I am totally kidding. It tastes like fucking ass and grass. I fill it up like to here with frozen spinach, one serving of Green Vitamins green powder, one teaspoon of turmeric, one teaspoon of ginger, and water to the top. And as soon as I finish my pancakes, I'm gonna chug this because it's really bad. All of my food is focused on two things: quality food. I'm just trying to pump my body because I am still trying to gain weight. So I'm trying to just pump my body full of as many quality, high protein, high nutrient dense foods. I avoid vegetable and soybean oil like the plague. Vegetable oil, I could make an entire series based on why vegetable oil is so bad for you. If you do grocery shopping and you just focus on the shorter the ingredient list, the better. So whole foods that you cook yourself. Gucci, I know, honey. I'll let them see you in just a second. And what was I saying? Okay, yeah. So shorten the list of ingredients that you buy and avoid vegetable oil. Just for fun, go through your food in your cabinet and look at everything that has vegetable, soybean, any processed oil in it that is rancid and highly polyunsaturated. Avoid it. I mean, there's no reason to have it in your diet whatsoever. It's unbelievably inflammatory for your body. It's rancid. It makes everything worse. So just if you do one thing, just general thing in your grocery shopping, avoid processed oils. Yeah, so that'll do it for this meal. I have my doctor's appointment coming up. Sutures come out today. Pumped about that. I'm just any opportunity to heal more and to be able to do more in therapy is a good thing right now. So sutures come out. Hopefully get the go ahead on pushing it harder in physical therapy. Today is Wednesday, July 14th, I think. I probably messed up the date three times in this video already. I haven't slept longer than like 3 hours since Friday. Today's Wednesday. My leg pain is just through the roof right now, but I know it's gonna get better. I'm still avoiding taking pain medication as much as I can. If it does get worse, I might start taking one just to get through the day because it's pretty bad. But other than that, come here, Gucci. You wanna say hi? Let's say hi. Let's say I'm only here for the food. Yep, so I will see you guys shortly at my doctor visit, probably, unless I cook another meal before that. What's up, guys? I tried taking a nap. My leg's just hurting too bad. I'm gonna try to see what the doctors say about that. I wanted to show you guys the Kodiak cakes that I was talking about, so that's them. It is 14 grams of protein a serving and 30 carbs, so a full cup serving that I had this morning is like, with an egg, it's basically 33 grams of protein, 60 grams of carbs, and like 10 grams of fat. It's a very hearty, like pre or post workout meal, I would say. And right now I'm about to make me a little snack to take on the road because I'm running behind per usual. Okay, I've got a cup of the Oikos 00 Greek yogurt. Not partial to this, I don't really care. Just kind of focus on macronutrients and probiotics with this. And I do a few tablespoons of this. This stuff is crack. You have to be really careful with it. Today has actually been kind of like a meatless day, unintentionally. I haven't had any meat yet. Still keep my protein really high. And then a kiwi, my favorite. Heading to the doctor now.
Oh, check out the glow. Videographer status. Hopefully it's blocking off the allergic reaction that I've had. Honestly, so my little brother's driving me to physical therapy right now. Say hi.
Hello.
I haven't had a full day of sleep in like 4 days, realistically. I'll sleep like 2 hours, wake up, pain, roll around, bitch, try to go back to sleep, doesn't work.
Okay, had to flip my phone around there. But like I said, on the way to therapy, sutures coming out, gonna get a lot of answers about what we can start doing for physical therapy, doctor. And yeah, other than not sleeping, I feel great, you know. Actually, that's a lie. My leg is killing me. I haven't slept, but what are you going to do? Things are going to get better one way or the other. They can only get so much worse. I honestly shouldn't say that out loud because now it's going to happen.
Okay, we're here being miserable with Leslie. Say hello.
Hi.
She is about to take these bad boys out. And then we're going to do some x-rays and continue to not be able to breathe. Oh. Okay, sutures are out. Just did some manual testing on my knee. Doesn't seem happy.
Doc said everything is healing well. See, I can feel like some tingling, but that's it.
And there's one right here, one for the ACL, one for the PCL. They're right next to each other.
Okay.
Now this is metal. That's the only metal internal brace you have. Those sutures, I said that we tied it into the graft. We anchor those right here and anchor that into your bone. Once again, okay. It offers a different point of fixation to strengthen that. You can see your screw up here holding the ACL in place. Let's see if we can get a better view. Oh yeah, look at this. This is
wow.
So you
let there be red light. So I am home from my doctor's appointment. It went great. As you guys probably saw, I got my sutures taken out. My range of motion looked pretty good. I got it past 90 degrees fairly easily. Still pretty much little to no quad activation, actually closer up to my knee, which is to be expected.
So red light therapy, if you've never heard of it, it's not a new modality, but it's becoming more popular, not just for celebrities and athletes, but it stimulates, it sends red and near infrared light throughout your body. So it affects you on a mitochondrial level and it stimulates ATP production. So immediately it's amazing for your skin, like awesome for your skin. You'll notice results in your skin first before anything. For me, it's great for increased energy, anti-inflammatory benefits. It helps with your circadian rhythm if you do it at morning and at evening, if you don't get a lot of natural sunlight. But yeah, doctor visit went great. I'm gonna go make my pre-workout meal here in a minute and head to the gym. So I'll see you there.
Okay, so just finished my red light therapy. About to do my home physical therapy. I'm gonna do a little timeless video of it. Drinking my pre-workout, kind of intra-workout drink. I do this most days. I try to drink this. It is 5 ounces of pure 100% beet juice, water equal parts, a little bit of salt, and creatine. If you've never had beet juice pre-workout, it fucking rocks. If your stomach can tolerate it, it's extremely good for blood flow. It is a precursor for nitrogen oxide production. Or it has nitrates in it that is a precursor for nitrogen oxide production. And it is awesome for blood flow and pumps before workout. I actually just ordered a really expensive pre-workout from Granite Supplements. The man himself, Mountain Dog, the owner of that company. I'm really excited about that. But going to knock this down, do a little therapy, and then head to the gym.
What's up, guys? So I'm going to take you through the majority of my workout today. I got cleared to unlock this bad boy. Hold her up. Same thing as always though, I'm just gonna do a good dynamic warm up. We're gonna bench today and then do a ton of back work. And then I'm gonna do some occlusion training at the end for just some extra blood flow and pump. And still, if you have an injury, whether it's arms or legs, it's called cross education. Yeah, cross education, where if you work one leg, there's still some carryover to the other leg that isn't being utilized. So we're gonna be doing that today. And yeah, let's get started.
two.
So my surgeon told me today, same thing, never expect to squat, do heavy lifting, walk normal, pretty much everything that I love, said I will never be able to do it again. Said it'd be a year before I could do most of the stuff that I used to do normally. That's status quo bullshit. And if you know anything about me, you're gonna learn that I fucking hate the status quo. Okay, just got home from the gym. It went awesome, I feel pretty good. My knee is extremely sore, but no painkillers. And on that topic, talking about anti-inflammatory foods after a workout. I am not a fan of doing vegetables or high antioxidant rich fruits immediately after workout. Follow me on this. The whole point of training causes inflammation in your body. And your body's natural response to gain muscle, lose fat, whatever your goals are, is literally to have your body heal that inflammatory response on its own. So if you start pumping your body full of anti-inflammatory foods or do your red light therapy or stuff, anything like that immediately after workout, it's kind of counterintuitive. So I like to keep nutrition extremely simple after workout. So I'm having some salmon and I got some rice going, but first, you gotta treat yourself. I tried doing this last time and it never came out, so. If your goal is performance, muscle gain, weight gain, anything like that, I think it actually helps with fat loss too. It really does. There's a lot of research behind that. Having some kind of simple carbohydrate, simple sugar immediately following a workout refills your glycogen storages in your muscles and gets you primed for the next workout. So yeah, just have something on hand. I'm not a huge fan of Gatorade powder. It's just got too much shit in it. But something like honey or a banana, some kind of like really sweet fruit, maybe a little orange juice after workout is not gonna hurt anything. All right, 200 grams of jasmine rice. I've got 10 ounces of salmon and I seasoned it with turmeric, garlic, salt, and pepper. I got some fresh limes here I'm gonna squeeze on top of it. Then I had this like leftover jalapeno pico de gallo concoction that I made. That's actually freaking delicious, so I just put that on the side. This is like pretty much like 100 grams of carbs and 50 grams of protein after a workout, which is exactly what I'm aiming for. All right, so basically just taking this magnesium lotion. And this hurts like a son of a bitch, so I just kind of do it. My shins are so sensitive to pain right now, it is unbearable, honestly. So I just kind of coat it, let it sink in. There's been a lot of research on doing topical magnesium in therapy. And I am guinea pigging myself, so we all know I will try anything if it alleviates some pain. This is what I mean, guys, by... really going all in. I'm taking this very seriously. I mean, I'm just doing everything that I know physically possible within my wallet range to heal. And I'm gonna take what I think works best, what doesn't work best, and you guys get to sidetrack all of it and just benefit from what works. I'm not joking when I say that my doctor said that he's never seen an injury like mine. So
guinea pig it is. I'm all about it. I'm here to learn more about my body, what I can do, what I can push through. So I'm going to make myself some popcorn and do my intro and outro videos.
Hey guys, just wanted to thank you so much for watching. Got my popcorn, doing some editing, got my honey with me. Today's been a good day. It's definitely been the best day I've had since my accident. So I really am glad that you got to come in. And I hope that you have a takeaway from something, whether it be nutrition or motivation or training. Whatever you got out of it made it worth filming. So I will see you in the next video.